Let's also this morning get you all the latest updates on the investigation into the Kerala gold scam. India Today has accessed the Customs Department report, which was submitted to the centre, where a left-backed MLA, Karath Razak's name has surfaced. Now, Soumya, who's the wife of one of the main accused, Sandeep Nair, has actually named Razak as well as a businessman, Karath Faisal, in her statement, which was recorded in July. Soumya told investigating agencies that her husband, Sandeep, and another accused, Ramesh, who's also in custody, they smuggled gold for MLA Razak and for Faisal. Now, the LDF-backed independent MLA has denied any involvement, alleging attempts to falsely implicate him. The NIA, meanwhile, has arrested Rabins Hamid, one of the absconding accused, in connection with the case. Hamid was deported by the UAE government. The probe has also revealed that Hamid purchased gold in Dubai, which was then smuggled to India. And let me take this across to Gopi Krishnanunithan, who's joining us live from Thiruvananthapuram. Gopi, good morning. Just break down for us now this fresh link that's emerged to the government. Another MLA who is linked to the left, his name is now cropped up. Who's named him really now?
Well, very good morning, Yakshita. So there are actually two developments that has come up since yesterday. So first is the arrest of Rabins Hamid, and that actually is seen as a huge breakthrough for the NIA and investigating agencies. Because in the past, they were actually referring to these particular names of KT Ramesh and this particular person as a crucial link in the case. But because he was in UAE, the NIA could not record his statement, or NIA could not go ahead with the investigation. But now that they have got this person in custody, the NIA feels that they can actually take this case forward and try and find the terror links in the case. Now, the second aspect is the reference towards the name of Karath Razak. He is actually a left-backed independent MLA. He's from one of the constituencies in Malappuram. And this name actually cropped up in the statement which was given by Soumya, that is the wife of Sandeep Nair. It's actually very interesting to see that this reference or this statement was given in July 8th, and it's been almost like 3-4 months, but the investigating agencies does not really seem to have taken this up seriously. Why we feel so is because till date, there has not been any reference about this particular MLA in any of the official documents. Neither he has been summoned, neither he has been questioned. So that it seems that the investigating agencies have not really taken this reference seriously, maybe because of the lack of proper evidence.
Okay, Gopi, we'll be tracking this very closely. As far as this independent MLA goes, he's categorically denied all the allegations against him.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.